been on my mind. Serving been on my mind, and here's why. You know, I was just sitting at home in California, minding my own business. But I could not stop thinking about what's going on down here.
People want to hunt in Georgia, but Hey, it's Taylor. Anybody got me there?
She cares about affordable housing, and she cares about criminal justice reform to protect our communities and creating jobs. So the reason I am a registered independent is because I believe that everybody should have the right to vote their values and vote your conscience regardless of the party. And I tell you, I have voted Republican and I have voted Democrat, and each time I voted for the people who I felt represented my values. So Stacey Abrams' values are in alignment with the consciousness of which our democracy has been founded. The very foundation of our democracy is to think about other people, to live a life in service to others. Individual rights and concerns and our individual protections, but rather it lives and thrives in making sure that everybody is lifted by the community. The baseline is not just what I want or what I need or what's going to fill my pocketbook, but recognizing that what is good for everybody is good for us. She gets that, she understands, and she will serve the underserved of the state of Georgia. Here's the truth. All of us may have been created equal, but if you awoke, if you woke just a little bit, you got sense enough to know that everybody is not treated equally. The reality is we see injustices, big and small, all around us every single day of our lives. And I know it's easy for a lot of people to feel that you have no power against those injustices. But this is what I'm here to tell you. This land was made for you and me. That's not just a song, that's the truth. And I will tell you that we are not powerless. Every single one of us, every single one of us has the same power at the polls. And every single one of us has something that, if done in numbers too big to tamper with, myself, I don't want to run, okay?
I'm not trying to test any waters. Don't want to go in those waters. I'm here today because of Stacey Abrams. And I'm here today because of the men and because of the women who were lynched, who were humiliated, who were discriminated against, who were suppressed, who were repressed and oppressed for the right for the equality at the polls. And I want you to know that their blood has seeped into my DNA, and I refuse to let their sacrifices be in vain. I refuse. And I'm here today. Don't let nobody turn you around. You can't let their sacrifices be in vain. I'm here today because, like a lot of young people, I didn't take voting seriously until around my mid-20s. And around my mid-20s, I had the privilege of hearing Reverend Otis Moss Jr., who's a preacher. Y'all know him? Preacher in Cleveland, Ohio. And I heard him tell the story of his father, of Otis Moss Sr., who right here in Georgia's Troop County, got up in the morning and put on his only suit and his best tie. And he walked 6 miles to the voting poll location he was told to go to in LaGrange. And when he got there, after walking 6 miles in his good suit and tie, they said, "Boy, you at the wrong place. You at the wrong place. You need to go over to Mountville." So he walked another 6 miles to Mountville. And when he got there, they said, "Boy, you at the wrong place. You need to go to the Rosemont School." And I picture him walking from dawn to dusk in his suit, his feet tired, getting to the Rosemont School, and they say, "Boy, you too late. The polls are closed." And he never had a chance to vote. By the time the next election came around, he had died. So when I go to the polls and I cast my ballot, I cast it for a man I never knew. I cast it for Otis Moss Sr., who walked 18 miles one day just for the chance to vote. And when I go into the polls, I cast the vote for my grandmother, Hattie Mae Lee, who died in 1963 before the Voting Rights Act of 1965 and never had a chance to vote. I vote for her. And when I stand in the polls, I do what Maya Angelou says: I come as one, but I stand as 10,000. For all those who paved the way that we might have the right to vote. And for anybody here who has an ancestor who didn't have the right to vote, and you are choosing not to vote, wherever you are in this state, in this country, you are dishonoring your family. You are disrespecting and disregarding their legacy, their suffering and their dreams when you don't vote. So honor your legacy. Honor your legacy. Honor your right to citizenship in this, which is the greatest country in the world. The greatest country in the world. And the right to vote is like the crown we all get to wear. Maya used to say, "Baby, your crown has been paid for, so put it on your head and wear it." So your crown's been paid for. The right to vote is your crown. So this is a tight race here in Georgia. This is tight. And there are tight races all over this country that depend on all of us giving honor to our greatest democratic right and privilege. So let your vote make a difference. Let your vote count. Let your vote speak for you. If you're a woman, let me just talk to the women for a minute. If you're a woman, you need to recognize it hasn't even been 100 years since we even had the right to vote, since we were considered a piece of property. You couldn't even own a piece of property. I love land so much, and I think, boy, if I was born at the turn of the century, 20th century, I wouldn't even have the right to own the land without your father or your husband saying it was so. You didn't have the right to even take care of yourself. So you didn't have a voice, and now we do. We as women people need to stand united and vote our values. Vote your values. Vote your conscience. All the noise, you just can't get away from it. You turn on the TV, on the way, it's so much noise and crazy talk. All the vitriol in the ads. You know what? They are designed to confuse and confound you with fear. That's what they're done. They're designed to confound you with fear. They are not designed for people with discernment. Women, people, we have discernment. And when you know the right thing and you can feel it, you can feel what is the right thing to do, you can't be influenced by propaganda and fear. So now is the time for discernment. And only when we unite as sisters, and I don't just mean sisters, I mean sisters, black sisters, brown sisters, white sisters, Asian sisters, LGBTQ sisters. When we all unite, I know for sure a change is going to come. So I'm here today to support a change maker. She's a woman who dared believe that she could change the state of Georgia. And she is dynamic. She is so inspired and inspiring. She's bold. She's bold. She's bold and bodacious. She's a Georgia warrior woman. Ladies and gentlemen, Stacey Abrams.